Alex Joseph Rabelais. Never in a million years did I think I was going to meet my one true love, the guy I'd spend the rest of my life with, the day that I met you. These past years, I have been such a whirlwind, and we have never been through so much, but I thank God our paths crossed when they did. You have been such a blessing to my life, and I can't thank you enough for all the joys and laughs you have brought me, all the things you have done for me, and all you have taught me about life and myself. You really are the perfect man for me, and I am so proud of who we are and what we are becoming. So I promise you this, to always be a team and to dream together and build together. As we both know, we are really young, but I promise you I will grow with you and never apart from you. Never will I let our stubborn minds and pride get the best of us. I will always stay humble and do my best to admit my wrongs. I may take a few shame walks to the kitchen with coffee cups, but I promise to always strive to be better. I promise to motivate and encourage each other to be the best that we can be. I vow to value our differences as much as our common ground. Wherever life may take us, I promise to stay by your side, as it says in Ruth 1:16. Where you go, I will go, and where you stay, I will stay. When distance is between us, I promise to be supportive, strong, and understanding, and I will be faithfully wait for my sweet soldier to come back to me. There is no obstacle that we cannot beat if we are together. I promise to always care for you in a kind, loving, nurturing way, and be patient with you and show appreciation for all you do. I promise to trust you even if life seems a little rocky, things are not quite going our way, or you take a little too much money to the casino. As long as you come home with one more dollar, we will be okay. I will always cherish our random slow dances, and I promise never to grow up too much that we can't play together and have tickle wars. So my dearest Alex, today seems like it's the start of a new journey, but I already belong to you. I will always be your best friend, and you will always be mine. I love you more. Your bride.
To my best friend and the love of my life, today we celebrate the blessing of marriage in the house of God and become one for as long as we both shall live.
She's gonna ruin her makeup.
Oh no, I can't read it. Read it for me.
Today we celebrate the blessing of marriage in the house of God and become one for as long as we both shall live. This is the opening of a new chapter and new journey as we are now courting, bonding into a family of our own. From this day forth, I promise that I will let love flow deep within my heart into your body and soul. I promise that I will always treat you with respect and speak to you with words of encouragement. For all of the challenges that you may be confronted with, I will be standing by your side to comfort and care for you. I will treat you with compassion and understanding when differences may arise. I promise to provide and build the foundation that our family will stand upon. I will remain faithful to you in this commitment. Most importantly, I will always keep Jesus in and center of our marriage. True love always wins, and I will love you forever and always. May God bless our marriage and all of the days to come. From Alex.
Good evening. Good evening. Are we sleeping? Good evening.
Good evening.
Oh, now you make me feel better. I'm Father Pacey. I'm pastor of Our Lady of Lourdes in Slidell, right across town. I'm happy to be with all of you this evening, Dallas, and Chelsea, on this their wedding night. And so we begin our prayer in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. We gather to pray for our friends, and we offer that great prayer of the angels, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Be attentive to our prayers, O Lord, and in your kindness uphold what you have established for the increase of the human race, so that the union you have created may be kept safe by your assistance. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated as we now listen to God's holy word.
Many are the troubles of the just one, but The head waiter called the bridegroom and said to him, "Everyone
than when the guests have been drinking freely an inferior wine. But you have kept the good wine until now. Jesus did this as the beginning of his signs in Cana in Galilee, and so revealed his glory. And his disciples began to believe in him. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. Again, we welcome everyone this evening, those who travel from afar. We come tonight at this solemn occasion for Chelsea and Alex. Isn't she beautiful?
Yes.
And he's a handsome fellow, too. I chose this gospel text because in this gospel text, Chelsea, Alex, family, friends, this is the recording of the very first miracle Jesus performed. And where did it take place? At a wedding reception. He turns the water into wine. But not just any wine, the finest wine, the best. Or as we say, huh? The creme de la creme here in Louisiana. Jesus turns this water into wine. And as he makes that water into wine, the creme de la creme, the best, he speaks to your heart and to mine. And he turns us into the best. He doesn't make second class, the best. Because Almighty God deserves the best on earth and in heaven. And so our blessed Lord listens to his mama. And he says that prayer and he produces that wine. Now I often wonder, what would have happened if he didn't do what his mother asked? I wonder how the scriptures would record that. We will never know. He was a good son and he listened to his mother. And he did great things. As we come together tonight to witness the wedding, the marriage, the love between Chelsea and Alex, we too are privileged to be included in this great occasion of great affection of the heart. We come because we have been invited, but we also come because we are happy for them. We are happy that they are together. And the thing will, God, by God's grace, will be together for many, 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 many years and bring forth many children. The fruit of your love will be those children. God saying to Alex and to Chelsea, this is the fruit of your love, these children. And the Lord calls us to co-create with him in many ways. As we will say the prayers at the altar, that bread will be changed into the Lord's body, and that chalice of wine will be changed into his blood. It's not symbolic, because on the night the Lord gathered with his apostles at the Last Supper, he said, this is my body. He did not say, this is like my body. He said explicitly, this is my body. This is my blood. Each time you gather, you do this in remembrance of me. And so we gather to give praise and glory to God for the gift Chelsea and Alex and the love that they share. And as we offer our prayers, we all participate. We all participate in a very spiritual way in praying for them. As we offer our prayers to Almighty God at this altar. So tonight as we continue with this Holy Mass, tonight as we continue to give witness to Alex and Chelsea's love for one another, let us continue to praise the Lord in our hearts, and let us allow the Lord to change us too, that we might all draw close to him each day. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Now I invite the wedding party to join me as I gather close to Chelsea and Alice as we exchange their vows.
My dear friends, you have come together in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's minister and this community. In this way, you will be strengthened to keep mutual and lasting fidelity with each other and to carry out the other duties of marriage. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Chelsea, Alex, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage? Will you love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives? Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church? Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, join your right hands and declare your consent before God and his church. I, Alex, take you, Chelsea, to be my wife. I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I, Chelsea, take you, Alex, to be my husband. I promise to be true to you. In good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life. You have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. What God has joined, men must not divide. I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Alex Rabelais. You may kiss the bride. Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Please stand. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. Receive, we pray, O Lord, the offering made on the occasion
of the sealing of the sacred bond of marriage. And just as your goodness is its origin, may your providence guide its course. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
your spirit. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you have forged the covenant of marriage as a sweet yoke of harmony and an unbreakable bond of peace, so that the chaste and fruitful love of holy matrimony may serve to increase the children you adopt as your own. By your providence and grace, O Lord, you accomplish the wonder of this twofold design, that while the birth of children brings beauty to the world, their rebirth and baptism gives increase to the church through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Through him, with the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Have mercy on us all, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Chelsea is going to present roses to her mother and mother-in-law, and then she and Alex will go to our Blessed Lady and offer a rose to Mary, the Mother of God. I invite the parents to please stand in your pew.
Now, if you'll kindly stand for the post-communion prayer and the final blessing. By the power of this sacrifice, O Lord, accompany with your loving favor, what in your providence you have instituted so as to make of one heart in love those you have already joined in this holy union, and replenish with the one bread and the one chalice, through Christ our Lord. Bow your heads and pray for God's solemn blessing. Please respond, Amen, at the end of each stanza. May God, the Eternal Father, keep you of one heart in love for one another, that the peace of Christ may dwell in you and abide always in your home. Amen. May you be blessed in your children. May you be blessed in your children, have solace in your friends, and enjoy true peace with everyone. Amen. May you be witnesses of the world to God's charity, so that the afflicted and needy who have known your kindness may one day receive you thankfully into the eternal dwelling of God. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thank you. You're jumping around like me.
How are you?